concept of time of sixth chapter of SST book of third class. Okay, so let us start. You know what is time, right? You might have seen calendar, weighing machine, digital clock, books, wristwatch, right? So these all are the things which shows time. Okay, let us see what is time. Time is very precious. Okay, it's very important. It tells us exactly when things are happening or have happened. Whatever have happened is also said by time only, and things which are going to happen is also said by time only. It also tells us when certain things will happen. Clocks and whatever is going to happen in future also it tells. Clocks and watches help us to measure time in seconds, minutes and hours. Okay, 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute, as we know. You might have read in maths class also. 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. 24 hours is equal to 1 day. Okay, so this has to be kept in your mind. This is the common things you should know about time. So we also have calendars that show us the days, weeks, month and years. We know that there is a calendar to show whether there is a holiday or not. Especially students, they want holidays. So at that time, the red mark is shown in the calendar. No, it is done in the calendar. So children will be very happy to see the red marks because it is a holiday time. So calendar shows the weeks, days, months and years. Okay. Now span of 1 year. What is the span of 1 year? A year means the time or period from 1 January to 31st December. As we know, there is a month called January, February, March, April, you don't know. So it comes in a year, okay? That means a period from 1 January to 31st January, sorry, December. So a year has 12 months. How many months are there? There are 12 months, okay? You know, a year have a 12 months. This time or period of 1 year is called the span of 1 year. That means 1st January till which December? 31st December is a span of 1 year. Okay. So this period of time is span of 1 year. Okay. Let's revise the names of the 12 months that make a 1 year. So children, you should know January, February by heart, and with the correct spelling you should know, because these are the months which you should know by heart. Okay, read it by yourself. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, with it, including the spelling. Okay, there are the activities, multiple choices, you do by yourself here. Now we'll come to decade. What is the meaning of decade? As you might have heard, no, after 10 years is a decade, okay? Because many of the school, many of the colleges, they celebrate one decade. Once it passes one decade, then they celebrate grandly, okay? So a decade means a period of 10 years, okay? 10 years is a decade. For example, the period from the year 2011 to 2020 will make one decade, okay? To make one decade, there must be 10 years gap, okay? 10 years, after 10 years, we can say a decade, okay? One decade is said after 10 years. We need to remember that a decade is a continuous period of 10 years. So, once after 10 years is finished, then we can say that we have passed one decade, okay? So, we have read two things. One is time. What is time? Span of 1 year. What is span of 1 year? So recall it, and you have to do it, and you have to by heart its definition too. Now we come to longer span of time. Collect the birth rate dates of your family members or your friends' family members, at least 4 members. Sequence the birthdays and make a list, as it is given here. It is given here of Mahesh Sharma, who is the oldest, I mean elder person in the family. That one, 23rd March, his birthday is 23rd March 1954. Like that, sequentially, it is kept. Renu Sharma, her grandmother, okay? That means This is also our second oldest family member of our family. So 4th December 1957. Like that, gradually they have kept, consequently they have kept Ramesh Sharma also, Rupali also, these all are the people according to their birth dates, okay? So these are the sequence, the birth dates, and make a list beginning with the eldest member of the family as shown in the sample list. As it is shown in the sample list, you can also make your own family members list. Who is the oldest one, who is the eldest one in your family, you can write your grandfather. Then afterwards, who is your second eldest one, you can write your grandmother's name. So like that, you have to continue writing. This is called a longer span of time, okay? Now answer the following questions. It is here, who is the eldest member in the family? According to this list, you have to answer, okay? Who is the eldest? Of course, Mahesh Sharma, because he is the one who is the eldest one. He is the grandfather here. Who is the youngest member in the family? Here, surely, Rupali Sharma, who is the youngest member, because her age is, her age is younger to everyone, okay? You just learned how to sequence a longer span of time. Now let's move to a century. What is a century? You know, you might have seen cricket, you might have seen volleyball match and all. So you say that a century means 100 years, okay? This is again a continuous and long span of time. So it is a 100 years, okay? So children, for today we will stop with this one. We will continue in the next class. As your timeline is also given, you need to read timeline also according to the birth, according to the date, month, whatever you have done, you have to complete it with this. And calendar, you know what is a calendar also, right? So calendar, family events, what are the family events you have here? You can have marriage ceremony, right? Festivals, anniversaries and all. So these all are the family events. And school events. School events are Children's Day, right? Teacher's Day. When is Children's Day? When is Teacher's Day? You should know. National events, Independence Day, right? And Gandhi Jayanti. These all shows the time. So let me conclude with all the this one. You have read about time span of 1 year. You need to know all the definition of it, okay? And decade, you know what is decade meaning? So these all other things comes under time, okay? Once we want to go to someone's birthday party, marriage ceremony, we just see in the calendar when is the date, so that you can beforehand you make sure that you will reach there on time, and you will start stitching clothes and all for the family events like birthday, anniversaries. By looking the time, you know that in spite of your work, you will make time to go, since you know when is their birthday, when is their marriage anniversary, and everything like that. So children, time is very precious. Please read in this chapter of every time span of time. You have to know the definition also, and you should understand also. So children, thank you for listening this, watching this video.